Good morning, everybody. It's now Wednesday. I don't know where the week has gone. I am back at my flat now. I fell asleep last night and forgot to finish the vlog. What a surprise. I also fell asleep three quarters of the way through Silent Hill, so I don't know what happened at the end, and I'm pretty sure it got really good after the part I fell asleep. So that's good. I've just got back to mine from Alfie's. I went and got my eyebrows done, finally, so now they actually look like eyebrows. And I have been doing lots of worky stuff this morning. Carrie's with me too. And now I have to go and do something for a secret thing that I can't tell you what it is, but you'll find out next week. So ha ha ha, I'm being really mean and making you wait, but I don't know. It will kind of explain a lot of things, basically. That's all I'm gonna say. Okay, I'm going there now. Just got back to the flat and it is now 10 to 3 already. I don't know where the day has gone. I have myself a BLT bagel and I'm about to watch some Great British Bake Off because it's the final tonight, so I want to catch up on the one before it, before I watch the final. And I also have myself a Costa hot chocolate because I really like Costa hot chocolates. They're really lovely. Really lovely. They're really lovely, those hot chocolates. And I also got myself juicy water because I do love a juicy water. Look at all my beverages lined up. Just filmed myself a video for something, and I've had a little, it had to be Christmas themed, where I pulled a cracker. So right now I'm feeling super festive. I've got my little Morris the Moose stocking there and a little bit of Christmas bunting across the fireplace. The fire's on, the candles are lit. It's Christmas. It's Christmas already and I'm loving it. And why does everyone always make these so massive? Literally, look at that. I could get another head in here with me. It's huge. Okay, so you may have noticed I'm now wearing a little red button. And I'm going to explain this for you because it's a brilliant concept and it's something that I'm really excited to share with you and something that I'm going to be working really closely with and I hope that you guys get involved in. Basically, it's World Mental Health Day tomorrow for you guys, so the 10th of November, and there's a campaign running alongside this called the Don't Panic campaign, and it's basically around the concept that whenever you see a red button, it normally means panic. So something like, let me show you this that I've got, my little panic button here. Normally, when you see red, you think, panic! But the whole concept around the Don't Panic campaign and Don't Panic button is that, oh my goodness, my flat is gonna break. Can you hear the wind? I can feel my flat moving. If I don't die tonight, then I am gonna have to leave this in your hands entirely, guys. I'm joking, I'm sure I'll be fine. Touch wood, somewhere. As you guys know, I suffer with anxiety and I've just teamed up with Mind to be their digital ambassador, which I'm really happy about. And I also really love talking about it and reassuring people that they're not the only one. And for me, it's a really important subject to always be brought up, and I'm guessing for those of you that do suffer with it, you can feel quite isolated and quite alone. So the concept of the Don't Panic button is that you can wear a red button, so just simply a red button. I've got a whole jar of them here, so they can be in any shapes and sizes, any kind of red button you like. It doesn't have to say Don't Panic on it. It can be anything. You can put it anywhere you like. You can make a little you can make a little button bow for your hair, you can put a little button around your plait, you can wear it on your coat, on your anywhere. You could wear it on your sock if you wanted to. You could honestly wear it anywhere you like. Kind of like a show of solidarity. That's a really hard word to say. For everyone out there who suffers with anxiety. So if you know someone that suffers with anxiety, or if you suffer with it yourself, so that if you see somebody else wearing a red button like this, then you can think to yourself, that person possibly suffers with anxiety or panic attacks or a form of mental illness, which then can kind of make you feel like you're not alone, and you can offer a little smile or give a little hug, or if they start to look uncomfortable, if you know yourself how it feels to feel anxious, you can offer some kind of support if you want to. You don't have to, but it's things like this that are kind of opening up the world to anxiety and panic attacks, and also making a lot of people realize that they're not alone, which is why I am so behind this campaign, and I really want people to like take this on board. So tomorrow for Mental Health Day, I want you to all who, if you suffer with anxiety or if you don't, or if you know someone who does, I want you to all tweet a picture with your red button wherever you want. You can get creative, you can have red buttons all over you if you want to, kind of like the new pearly queen or pearly king of red buttons, or just a simple red button somewhere, and just upload it to Twitter or Instagram and hashtag it Don't Panic Button. And I feel like as a massive community, we can really make a difference with this, and I love this concept so much. And I also just want to add, if any of you want any further information or advice on anything relating to anxiety, panic attacks, or mental health, I will leave links in the description box and also to any previous videos where I've discussed it. I'm really excited about this, and I hope that lots of you get involved and we all show each other how much support we can give each other and come together as a community and make life a little bit easier for those of us who don't find it quite so easy. And since this just looked super cute with all the buttons in and it had the hashtag in it, there you go guys, that's the hashtag Don't Panic Button, and this is my selection of buttons now that I'm going to be handing out to everyone that comes into my flat. Carrie's already got one and she's actually going to put it on her jacket tonight, so there we go. Awesome, showing our support, and yay! I'm quite obsessed with looking at all these buttons, I'm not going to lie. Look at them, look at this one. Okay, I need to stop. I feel like a magpie. I'm just waiting for Alfie to ring my buzzer in order to let me know he's outside, as we're gonna pop to Waitrose, because that pasta bake I mentioned in yesterday's video didn't get made today. Yeah, not yesterday's video, video before for you guys. So I really wanna make it. So we're gonna go and get some ingredients and then we're gonna make some pasta bake. I'm also watching the Great British Bake Off final, and I'm gonna miss it, so I've set it to record so we can watch it when we get back. And I'm going through my emails, and I'm munching on some Doritos. Does I have a headache? Hurry up, Alfie.
Hello?
Bang! You took so long. Come on, let's
go. Yeah, taxi driver. Long head.
We're in Waitrose now, guys. Alfie's looking at saucepans.
Getting, I think my mum's got one of these ones. That's why I'm looking at it. Maybe I've got one.
Alfie's wearing my hoodie, but I think it looks really nice on him. He's not so sure.
I'm not sure about my hair.
Also, I'm trying to teach him that he has to scan everything because he's putting everything in the trolley and not scanning it. We bought these little things to make our pasta bakes, and so we've got individual pasta bakes. And I feel like that way we won't overcook for two people, because obviously that can be quite an easy thing to do. Where's the pasta sauce? This way, Alfie. Well, these are nice. These like wooden things. They're quite nice. And this, look, serving board. It's quite nice. I've got these. Look, Christmas.
Too early.
Look at him trying to decide what milk. It's like, oh, I must get one with a good date on it. Does anyone else do this when they get milk? Look at him. Oh, Jesus. Alfie, the shop's gonna close soon. We should probably just grab some milk and go. I'm picking up this magazine because I really like Good Homes. I think they have some really nice interior stuff. And it also has a Christmas magazine on the other side, so that was kind of a winner for me. The best cakes, stockings, and wreaths. Get ready for Christmas.
Do you remember I bought that toilet roll the other day and you were like, what was it? It was so soft.
Change of subject slightly. Oh my God, no, Christmas cards. No. For a very special couple, Merry Christmas. I could get this for Tanya, Jim, Marcus, Naomi, Marzia, Felix,
Joe
and Casper. To both of you, Happy Christmas. Oh my God, how cute. Where's to Alfalfa? No, they don't have one for you, Alfie, sorry. Do you know what I do need? Post-it notes. Who doesn't have post-it notes? Me,
why
that's
do
who.
You need post-it notes?
Because I do.
What for?
Every time I go to grab a post-it note to write a note on it, I don't have it
you
to write
got
on.
Notes from your computer.
I know, but sometimes it's easier to just write these and stick them on things to remember stuff. I just got my camera out to scan these. I didn't mean to. I meant to grab that.
What do you up to?
I'm making a pasta bake. For me and Alfie, I'm doing two little separate ones because we saw these little pots in Waitrose and we thought they looked really cool. And now I've done the main thing, I'm going to scoop some mascarpone on there. And then I'm going to sprinkle some cheddar and parmesan.
Delicious.
And then pop it in the oven.
Good.
Happy?
So happy.
This is the final pasta bake. So it's got cheddar, don't touch it, it's hot. Cheddar, mascarpone, parmesan, bacon, tomato, basil, and pasta. And this one's mine. Yum, yum. And we're going to watch the bake-off final. We've got it paused right now. I've still left my Christmas stuff up. I kind of feel like it looks great.
No, we're not leaving that up.
I'm going to go and wash my face and go to sleep because I'm so tired. Look at this one.
Yeah.
Pokey pokey. Getting up early tomorrow. Heading into London. Oh, my back hurts when I breathe in. I think I'm just falling apart. And I'm super tired, and I actually just want to end one of my vlogs for once because I always forget to end them. So this is me ending my vlog. Good night, guys. Say good night. Say good night.
Good night.
Alfie's ear says good night.